I am going to walk us through the three different options for schema changes and how all of those work. So the first one is allow safe schema changes. This is the default option for any new job that's created in Domo. And a description of what that means is available right here. So we can see that for this particular option, unprotected columns accept changes during the next execution and are automatically protected afterwards. I'll also add that for this option, if a column is unprotected and schema changes do not happen, that column will remain unprotected until a schema change does happen. And then also new columns are added and automatically protected. So for this particular job, I am going to unprotect this column, the orders column, and we'll change this long to a string. I'm also going to add a new column to this data set. So if I come to the end, just add a test column and then add some numbers just as an example and then save that. And then we'll save that and then execute the job. And I can see that job executed successfully. And then my new column came in protected. And then my orders column was changed to a string and then it was reprotected. So that is the first option. The second option is allow unprotected schema changes. And this is different from the first option in a couple ways. If I unprotect a column and then I make changes, that column will continue to stay unprotected even after schema changes happen. And then in addition to that, new columns are added, and when they are added, they are left unprotected. So this option is a little bit more fluid on schema changes, and if that's something that you want for a particular column in your data set or for the entire data set, this is a good option for you. And what this will look like, let's say that I unprotect this column and then I change it back to a long. And then let's come in here and add another new column. I'll call this column test 2. Add some data as well. And then save that. If I save this and then I execute this with the allow unprotected schema changes option, I'm going to execute that. Now that that's executed successfully, I can see that in my orders column, it was successfully changed back to a long data type, and that column remains unprotected. And then my new column, test 2, was added to the data set successfully, and it was left unprotected. So that is the more fluid option for schema changes. The last option is the most safe. So if I want to block all schema changes, this essentially means no changes will happen to this data set. No columns can be added, as indicated here. And then any schema change to any of the columns will result in an error. So any changes to the data type, any changes to column names, or destination column names will prevent a job from executing successfully. And you can see one big change in this particular option is that the protect column is hidden because all of the columns are protected by default. So if I try to make a change while block all schema changes is selected, and if I try to add a new column, so let's do that, add another column, and then save that, and then we'll see what happens when I try and execute the job while block all schema changes is selected. Yeah, so now I can see that the Stravella orders failed to execute, and then it tells me here why. So I added a new column, the orders string, I tried to change orders to a stream and I couldn't. And then I tried to add a new column and then I couldn't as well. And Workbench will tell me that the reason is because safe schema changes have been disabled. So that is the most safe option and will prevent any schema changes from happening to your dataset without your explicit permission. And that is a quick walkthrough of how the three different options work for schema changes in Workbench.